Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys about polymorphism in Java. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Polymorphism. This is a Greek word for poly, meaning many, and morph, meaning form or forms. It's the ability of an object to identify as more than one type. Think of it as being identified as more than one data type. Here's an example. Let's say we're going to have a race, and we can enter in all different sorts of vehicles into this race. They don't all have to be the same. So we have a few additional classes, a class called Vehicle. Vehicle is going to act as the parent class for my class Car. So Car extends Vehicle, Bicycle, Bicycle extends Vehicle, and Boat, Boat extends Vehicle. So Car, Bicycle, and Boat are all subclasses or children classes of the Vehicle superclass. So let's create an instance of our Car, Bicycle, and Boat. Luckily, through the magic of copying and pasting, I have done that already. We have a Car object, a Bicycle object, and a Boat object. So let's store, well, at least attempt to store, all of these objects within an array called Racers. Racers equals, and then we will place our Car, Bicycle, and Boat within this array. So what's the data type of this array going to be? Well, we're going to have a problem. Could we make this Cars? Well, we could store our Car object within an array of Cars, but not our Bicycle and our Boat. The same thing goes for Bicycle. We could store our Bicycle, but not the Car and the Boat. And lastly, with the Boat data type, we can store the Boat, but not the Car and the Bicycle. And to solve this issue, we can use the power of polymorphism. So, for example, our Car identifies as a car, but since it extends the Vehicle class, it also identifies as a vehicle. Same thing goes with our Bicycle and our Boat. So, one thing they all have in common is that they are all vehicles, so we can change the data type of this array to vehicles, and therefore, we can store our Car, our Bicycle, and our Boat, because all of these objects also identify as vehicles. So if you're going to store objects within an array, and they're all different object types, you would have to find what they have in common and make an array of that type. So that's how to store different objects within an array using polymorphism. And now for our race, we're going to call a go method that we're going to define within each of our classes Car, Bicycle, and Boat. So let's begin with Car. Let's create a go method. So let's make this public. Void, it's not returning anything. And this will be called go. So when we call this method, all we'll do is have a println statement. System.out.println. Let's say something like, the car begins moving. Okay, let's repeat the process for bicycle and boat. Let's change car to bicycle. And within the boat class, car to boat. So each of these methods, well, each of these classes, has their own go method. And we could call them individually, kind of like this, car.go, bicycle.go, and boat.go. So this would work, but there's actually a better way to write this. And what would be better is if we were to create an enhanced for loop to iterate through all of the elements of this array of vehicles. So the data type for this enhanced for loop is going to be vehicle. We'll use x as our counter, colon, and then the name of the array, which is racers. So this is going to iterate once through all of the elements of this array of vehicles called racers. X represents the vehicle we are currently working with. So X dot, and we would like to use the go method. So our enhanced for loop doesn't care what kind of vehicle you are, if you're a car, a bicycle, or a boat. It cares that you're a vehicle. And if you're a vehicle, use your go method, whatever kind of vehicle you are. So there's one more step to this too. The method go is undefined for the type vehicle, so we need to make sure we have this go method within our class of vehicle, and I just generated that here. So what we're doing is actually method overriding within the car, the bicycle, and the boat class. So this isn't necessary, but it's considered good practice to add the add override annotation to each of these methods. And then our enhanced for loop is going to iterate through all of the elements of our array of vehicles called racers. So it doesn't care what kind of vehicle you are. If you're a vehicle, use your go method. Well, luckily, our car, our bicycle, and our boat all also identify as a vehicle. So that's all that polymorphism is. It's the ability of an object to identify as more than one type. Think of it as identifying as more than one data type. Our car does identify as a car, but it also identifies as a vehicle. Same thing can be said with our bicycle and our boat. But not only that, all objects are children classes of the object class, so they also identify as objects. So you could write this using the object data type, but there's a few other changes that we would have to make. So that's all that polymorphism is. It's the ability of an object to identify as more than one type. So if you would like a copy of all this code, I will post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of polymorphism in Java.
Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.